I've used Waves plugins on everything from Notorious B.I.G. Mo Money, Mo Problems to Mary J. Blige, Share My World to Beyonce, Crazy in Love to Jason Mraz, I'm Yours, all the way, past 10 years. Used a variety of Waves plugins. And one of the biggest reasons why we are working together is they make great stuff. I work from a rotating bank of presets because I'm always saving my presets for the plugins that I use. And it works both for outboard gear as well, of course. There are combinations of things that I'm using, plug-in, outboard gear. In the case of Waves, they make the Q clone, which I use as a clone to some of the outboard EQs that I use daily. So when I run out of EQs, I'll clone one and use that as a plug-in, and it also allows me to bring a recall back quite easily. And still have that sound that I was using on the analog. To have those banks of presets, those template of plugins that I would use on a particular instrument or as an effect for a particular instrument, readily available to me. That was the impetus that brought me to creating these plugins. So these plugins were formulated and put together so that they would be, one, easy to use for that purpose, and that they were effective in that purpose. They are not meant to be an everything plug-in. They absolutely are not to mimic my equipment. They are not meant to mimic any equipment. They are just meant to be a tool. So let's have a look at the plug-ins. The first one that I'm going to look at is the B72, which is a bass plugin, or what it would be my bass starting point. There are two main settings. One is what we call a DI setting, and the other is a synth setting. The song that I'm playing is a Jason Mraz track that I mixed called Live High. There's without the plugin. There's the plug-in in, and then I've got adjustments to add some top end, add some bottom end, take some top end out. I'm going to play it from the start again. And then again, there's the plug-in out, and the plug-in in. Now, if we go to the synth setting, you'll hear immediately a wider bass sound and overall a bit more buzzy because it was meant to be just that. On this one, I'll just dial it down a little bit. And you can hear with the sensitivity knob, I'm reducing the overall spread and buzziness. And of course, we've got presets that you'll be able to load. And in this case, I've got control of the effect. So here you can hear it's quite dry. And then here we get a little wider again. And I can reduce the top end, as always, and increase the output. So you can put these plugins directly on an insert, or you can use them as a bus. Now I'm going to backtrack and work a bit with what we've created to help with drum sound. We're hearing dry signal, and there's without the plug-in. There are a variety of settings here that we can manipulate as well. Output is always included in this Maserati plug-in group. We've also got a top-end boost, and the amount of what I call snap, and as I described it earlier, that would be the compression and the slow attack compression. and you can kind of lower the amount of compression involved. In this case, we've also got what we call a thump factor, which you kind of need with the snap factor up, in my opinion. Break section. And that's in. And this is out. I am going to solo the snare as well. And this is bypassed. And I'm going to put it on the snare top. And you can see how that makes it snap. In this case, crack a little bit. Now, if I add that bottom snare without anything on it whatsoever, you'll hear the combination of the two works quite nicely. And here's the bypass. And you can hear how soft that is overall. And that's with the plug-in in. I'm going to look at the snare top that we worked on, which is set for the snare top. Now, if I bypass that, you can immediately hear less crack, less snap, less presence on that top snare mic. I'd like to talk about the HMX plugin that we've created. This plugin was actually inspired by this Liz Wright track called My Heart, produced by Craig Street, and mixed it at my place. One of the beginning plugins that I needed. And again, I put it together based on the templates and presets that I had been using and the need that I had for a plugin that allowed me to create some space for Rhodes, Wurlitzers, even strings I've used it on. So it can be used for a variety of things. The VX plugin gives you a starting place to work with for vocals in this case, but you can use this on a variety of things.
If you want some loving, baby.
We've got a little bit of audio, and this is Liz Wright. If you want some, and you can hear that. That's a bypass signal there.
I can hook some too.
All I want, baby. And there's a signal with the VX in on the female you. 1 setting. I can put it on female 2.
Just a little bit of tension.
You can hear a little bit of room coming in there.
It's gonna see.
I'm gonna add a little bit more room with the effects knob.
'Cause you know you're my kind.
And as you can hear right away.
And I want you to be mine.
As you can hear right away, the room comes up. There's also a bit of some subtle modal effects happening, pitch effects happening on this. These plugins are made to be versatile, so they can be used in different sections with different types of vocal, hard vocals, soft vocals, subtle effects, and more over-the-top effects.